So my name is N. Vishwanath. Good afternoon. I am handling electronic circuit analysis in this semester, second semester. Electronic circuit analysis subject is a core subject for electronics and communication engineering people. So in this electronic circuit analysis, so most of the time students will learn regarding amplifiers. That is amplifier. So amplifier is an electronic circuit which increases amplitude level of applied input signal. So here input will be applied VL. So that is sinusoidal signal. Applied input signal is a sinusoidal signal. That is denoted by VI versus T. It will have time period T and zero reference axis, positive amplitude and here negative amplitude. Okay, this is a sinusoidal signal. The sinusoidal signal is applied to the amplifier circuit. So which is in the range of millivolts. Millivolt signal is applied to an amplifier. Okay, this amplifier amplifies this signal and gives output. Output is taken across output of an amplifier. Okay, that is denoted by V naught. And here we will get inverted signal. Inverted signal V naught versus T. Okay, this is also having minus negative amplitude reference axis and positive amplitude. Okay, this is time period of, this is denoted by capital T. So here output will get in the range of volts. The amplifier main purpose is for amplification. So general example of amplifier use is public addressing system. So in seminar halls, in a huge crowd, these amplifiers are used increasing amplitude level of applied input signal to boost the signal, to increase the magnitude signal. So for that one, special type of speakers are used, like in megawatts, kilowatts, speakers are used. So here the input is applied to an amplifier is very very small signal with an amplitude level positive and negative amplitude. The range is millivolts. If you apply this small signal to an amplifier circuit, so amplifier will give gain, that is generated by AV. Here AV is equal to V naught by VI. Voltage gain is generated by output voltage by input voltage. The AV is very important parameter of an amplifier. The general characteristics of an amplifier. The general characteristics of an amplifier are input resistance very important. Input resistance ideally infinity, and practically it is very large. And input impedance must be on. Next one, coming to output resistance. Output resistance ideally zero, it should be zero, and practically it should be low output resistance, because it should not load output current, output voltage. Why? Because output voltage we should have large compared to input voltage. If loading effect is more across output, so we will not get output voltage maximum. In order to get voltage gain maximum, loading resistance must be low. Okay, this is a second parameter. One is input resistance and followed by output resistance. Next, voltage gain. Voltage gain should be high. Voltage gain should be high for amplifier circuits. Similarly, current gain should also be high for amplifiers. And power gain, where power gain is voltage gain into your current gain AL. The product of voltage gain and current gain is known as your power gain. These are the parameters. Next, one more parameter, the bandwidth. The bandwidth of the amplifier should also be high. Bandwidth. These are the very important parameters regarding amplifier. So regarding amplifier circuit, regarding amplifiers, the analysis part we studied in this electronic circuit analysis course. Analysis, electronic circuit is just a closed circuit or open circuit. In electronic circuits, we have capacitors, inductors, resistors, components. followed by energy sources like voltage source, current source. So here analysis means obtaining these parameters, analyzing these parameters. Approximate analysis we have, exact analysis we have. So analysis of calculation of this input resistance, output resistance, voltage gain, current gain, power gain and bandwidth is done in this course. Ultimately students able to learn different types of amplifiers and their analysis and also designing in the sense designing input resistance, output resistance and voltage gains. And analysis means calculation of all parameters comes under analysis part. So now this is an amplifier. Next, coming to classification of an amplifier. Classification of an amplifier. So here amplifiers are classified based on different parameters. The first parameter based on output signal, amplifiers are voltage amplifier, current amplifier, and last one is here power amplifier based on output signal. So voltage amplifier is an electronic circuit in which the output signal is voltage. Next, current amplifier is an electronic circuit in which the output parameter is current. Next, power amplifier is also very important amplifier, which is also known as large signal amplifiers, like the class A, class B, class AB, class C, class D power amplifiers we have. The efficiency of power amplifier is very very important. Okay, this is based on output signal. If output signal is voltage amplifier, if output of amplifier is current signal, then it's current amplifier. If power signal, it is a power amplifier. This is based on output signal. Next, second classification based on input signal. Based on input signal, amplifiers are two types. One is small signal amplifier, and another one is large signal amplifier. Based on input signal, amplifiers are two types. One is small signal, another one large signal. So the small signal means, what do you mean by small signal amplifier? In this one, the input applied input voltage is very small. That is in the range of millivolts. The input applied to this amplifier circuit is very small. That is in the range of millivolt signal. That is called small signal amplifier. Next, coming to large signal amplifier, that is VI. The input voltage applied will be greater than your threshold voltage VD. Threshold voltage approximately, this will be 0.7 volts for silicon transistor. 0.VI is greater than VD. 0.7 volts. So this is a large signal amplifier. This is a second classification. Next one, third classification of our amplifier is based on configuration of BJT. First one, they are classified into three types. That is, first one, common emitter amplifier, common base amplifier, common base amplifier. See, common collector amplifier. So it is based on configuration of BJT. bipolar junction transistor, we have three terminals. That is emitter, base and collector. Bipolar junction transistor, okay, that is NPN transistor, we call okay, this is BJT or NPN transistor. NPN transistor, we have three terminals, emitter, base and collector. Okay, this is called bipolar junction transistor symbol, BJT, simply it is called BJT, bipolar junction transistor. So based upon the particular terminal connected between input and output, say here common emitter, this is called common emitter amplifier, because emitter terminal will be common for input signal at the same time output signal. So it is common between input and output. Input operate across base and emitter terminal, and output is taken across collector and emitter terminal. Right? This is common emitter amplifier. Similarly, base terminal is common for both input and output. The transistor here will connect like this. Okay, here this is emitter terminal, collector, this is emitter, collector, and base. So emitter will be grounded and input applied between emitter and base terminal, input signal. Next here will connect output signal between base and collector terminal. So hence it is called common base amplifier. Next followed by common collector. So your collector terminal is common for both input and output. So this is based on configuration of BJT. So next one, next classification of amplifier. Next classification of amplifier is based on bandwidth, based on bandwidth parameter. So one more classification is based on bandwidth. Based on bandwidth, amplifiers are classified into two types. One is narrow band amplifiers, and second one is wide band amplifiers. Okay, this classification is based on bandwidth. So your bandwidth, so this is bandwidth, narrow bandwidth and wide bandwidth. So name itself we can understand from this, narrow band. Narrow means your frequency is narrow, whereas wide band means the frequency range will be wide. So I will show the diagram of wide band amplifier. So if we calculate wide band amplifiers a frequency response analysis, we will get this frequency response very narrow. Okay, this is gain in dB. Gain in dB versus your frequency, if you calculate frequency in hertz, if you calculate, okay, this peak point is denoted by FC, center point, and lower cutoff frequency is denoted by F1 and IR is denoted by F2. So here bandwidth is F2 minus F1. So here bandwidth is very very narrow in narrow band amplifier, because narrow band amplifier is specially used in radio amplifiers, radio amplification, radio signal amplification, audio signal amplification. Whereas wide bandwidth, if you see wide bandwidth amplifier, if you see frequency response curve, it will be wide. I hope you can understand clearly based upon this frequency. There is a gain in dB versus your frequency, if you observe in hertz. So your bandwidth is here large. So this is F1 and this is your F2, right? So this bandwidth is more, F2 minus F1. Okay, this is 3 dB gain, minus 3 dB gain reference size. Okay, this is wide, right? Frequency response is wide. So from this I can conclude, okay, this narrow band is frequency response narrow, and this is used in television application. Okay, this is used in radio application. Thank you very much for patient listening. Thank you.